The original workload of Office 365 was Exchange Online. Exchange Online was actually the catalyst for Office 365, Microsoft's first cloud-based service. It used to be part of something called the Business Productivity Online Suite, or BPOS. Smartly, Microsoft decided to rebrand that as Office 365. And now we can still manage all Exchange settings through this Exchange Admin Center, this management tool for Exchange that lives within Microsoft 365. So if I go under my Admin Centers, I see here my Exchange Admin Center, and I'm going to click on that to open it. So here I'm opening the Exchange Admin Center. It's a classic Admin Center. It has the previous view of Admin Centers, which used to be common to all Microsoft portals. Today, that view is mostly refreshed to a cleaner view, a more simple view with less objects to manage or interfaces that are regrouped of their objects. And the Exchange Admin Center is really the tool that we'll use to manage anything that has to do with email and exchange of information via email and SMTP, or Simple Message Transfer Protocol, which is the protocol that is used to exchange email messages over the internet. So when I click on Recipients, for example, I will see that here I have my list of all users of my organization that have an email address. Every user that has an email address that can receive or send email is referred to as a recipient. And in a later video in this course, we'll look at recipients in details. But the reason why I click on this interface is to show you that I have a link now for the new Exchange Admin portal. So Microsoft is in the process of creating a new portal that has that new modern view of settings. And we're going to go ahead and click on that in a couple minutes. But first, I just wanted to show you how we have here a number of settings. And these settings all relate to email, but many of those settings are being moved to the Security and Compliance Center. Others are being moved to the new Exchange Admin portal. And some other, again, are still managed under the Microsoft 365 admin portal. So for example, here under my recipients, all of these users here, I can go ahead and create them from Microsoft 365 and give them an email address from Microsoft 365. For example, Zachary that I created earlier, I was able to give him his email address, which is listed here, and he was completely created from Microsoft 365 Admin Center, even though he has an email address now. As well, I have my compliance management. As I mentioned, the e-discovery and retention tags, and everything that has to do with the journaling, which is cataloging the content over time, all of that is now done from Security and Compliance. As well, if I go under my organization, I have here my sharing that allows me to define how I share information with external recipients. Those are settings that are specifically Exchange related. This is about sharing calendar data, or what we used to call as free busy information, availability of information. This information, how it's shared, it's very specific to email because it's held within the calendar, which is a property of the email account. Now, this is a setting that we do not have under Microsoft 365 or Azure Active Directory or Security Compliance. It's an email setting. So we see that there are a number of settings that live within the Exchange Admin Center. Some of them will retain, some of them will be moved. But this is a dynamic Admin Center. There are certainly a lot of things that are changing when it relates to Exchange Admin Center. So if we want to see a little bit about what the future looks like, let's go ahead and try the new Exchange Admin portal. And you'll notice right away under Recipients, a simplified view. Here I have my users that are listed. I have their email addresses that are listed. And let's go down and look for Zachary that's here. And I have his user mailbox. So that is the underlined category for the user mailbox. And then I have all of the settings for the email account. These are all the recipient settings for his account. Then under here, I can also specify the creation of user accounts. I can create new recipients. I can manage my recipients. I can delete recipients if I want. There's a lot of things that I can do from here, but it's still limited. For example, if I click under resources and I click add a resource here, it actually doesn't work. The link doesn't do anything. If I go under mail flow and go under message trace, I get a big coming soon message here. So again, this is a very dynamic portal. It's being built right now. It is the future of the portals within Microsoft Office 365 portals. So this one follows the view that we find for the SharePoint admin portal or the OneDrive or the Microsoft 365 admin portal. It is being refreshed for that.